Welcome to the How to GM tutorial on Roll20. In this video, we'll cover everything from the basics of the Roll20 virtual tabletop, like the toolbars and icons, to pro subscriber features that can help step up your GMing game, like dynamic lighting and mod scripts. Before we get started, let's go ahead and have an overview of the tools on the toolbar found on the left side, and we'll go from the top to the bottom. You have your settings, the select tool, the pan tool, the draw tool, the text tool, the effects tool, the lighting tool, fog of war, the measure tool, turn order, and dice. For GMs, the bottom half of the toolbar is an easy way to toggle between the different layers of the map. You have the token layer, the GM layer, the light layer, and the map layer. It's also helpful to note that the effects, lighting, fog of war, turn order, and layer section is only visible to the GM of the game. Over on the right-hand side, we first have the zoom tool. Then you have the sidebar. There are seven different icons that you can toggle in between, and these include text chat, art library, journal, compendium, jukebox, collections, and my settings. And last but not least, we have the folders and page toolbars where you can add new pages and folders to organize your game, search for a specific map or page, and also access the party toolbox to manage your players on multiple pages or regroup them together. First and foremost, let's dig into tokens on the Roll20 virtual tabletop. The first thing we have to do, of course, is to create a token. To create a token, drag and drop an image on the objects and tokens or the GM info layer on the virtual tabletop. It's as easy as that. With this token, you can also resize and rotate. To resize, use the corner handles, and to rotate, use the rotation handles. Let's take a quick look at the token layout and information. You can use radial bubbles for metrics, enable dynamic bars, and display a nameplate if needed. If you click on the cog, you'll be able to access the token settings. Within the token settings, you'll be able to customize details, the bars, the auras, and more. And lastly, here are some additional features when it comes to tokens. You can add markers for status effects, configure token toolbars, use auras, and set up GM notes and dynamic lighting for the tokens. Time to talk about using macros on Roll20. Macros are custom shortcuts for frequently repeated commands that you use during your games. Head over to the Collections tab on the sidebar. To enter a macro, first, type what you want to call the command, for example, test. Then, you can put in the command. This could be a type text, a role, or an emote. One of the strengths of the macro system is its ability to execute multiple actions with a single command. To do this, simply put each item on its own line, and the actions will be executed in that order when you run the macro. Now, let's look at rollable tables. A rollable table is a collection of items in which a single item will be chosen at random. It can be used to create custom dice, critical success or critical fail tables, loot tables, or any other list of items that need to be rolled. Rollable tables are found under the right-hand sidebar under the Collections tab. To start a table, click Add, and you'll get a new table with zero items. To add an item, click Add Item and name it. By default, the name you enter will be shown directly in the chat box if the item is selected when the table is rolled. Lastly, let's check out card decks. Card decks in Roll20 are a collection of one or more card objects that can be shuffled, drawn, dealt to players, traded between players, and played directly to the tabletop. Every game created has a deck of 54 standard playing cards, including jokers, as well as a safety deck by default in the Collections tab, but you can create your own as well. The Journal tab is your go-to hub for managing characters, handouts, and other essential information for your game. First, let's look at the character journal entries. These are for your PCs, NPCs, character sheets, and link tokens. From here, you can click the plus character button or right-click an existing folder to add character. When you right-click, these options will allow you to show, archive, or delete. Character tab will allow you to edit bio and info, character sheets, and attributes and abilities. Within bio and info, you can update the name, who can edit and control, and set the avatar, token, and bio. Character sheets have essential information like abilities, skills, equipments, and attributes, and can also be managed from Roll20 characters. Attributes and abilities track stats on the character and stores dice roll and other chat commands. There are also handouts that you can check out. You can click the plus handout button to open up the handout dialog. You can use the pop-out button if you need a little more room to edit. From here, GMs can show the handouts to the players, rename the handout, add to players' journals, update who can edit the handout, as well as look at tags, images, descriptions, and GM notes. And don't forget, you can also duplicate, archive, and delete handouts. And of course, there are ways for you to organize your handouts. You can add, move, and delete folders and minimize individual entries. For subscribers, external journal entries are controlled via the Game Details page under the Content drop-down menu. And one cool overlooked feature is linking between journal entries. To link between journal entries, use single brackets around the character or handout name. This can be used in the character bio, GM notes, and handout notes. Likewise, you can also link characters, tokens, and compendiums. It's time to roll for initiative with a combat tracker. The Roll20 Turn Tracker helps manage anything turn-based or reliant on initiative checks in your campaigns. To access this, click on the Turn Tracker button on the toolbar. Only the GM can open it, but once open, the Turn Tracker will be visible to all players. Right-clicking on any token on the tabletop allows you to add turn from the menu, and you can add one or multiple turns. GMs can also add turns for tokens on the GM layer without players seeing. Some character sheets, like the D&D sheet, have the option to roll for initiative directly from their sheet. You can add a value next to each token to keep track of initiative or any other stat that you want to note about that turn. You can click and type or drag and drop any roll result. Turns can be reordered via dragging or sorted using the turn order setting button. You can also click the arrows to go forward or back in the turn order. Dynamic lighting, available to Plus and Pro subscribers, updates your players' lines of sight in real time. And it's super easy to set up too. Let me show you. For your maps, use the page settings to turn on dynamic lighting and tailor it to your liking. On the dynamic lighting layer of your map, you can use the drawing tool to create walls, columns, doors, or other pieces of the map that you want to block light and vision. You can create dynamic lighting barriers that do not block vision, but do block movement. You can also make barriers that only block vision from one direction, while allowing tokens to see from the other side through. Lighting your dungeon is super easy with the Place Light tool. Don't forget to enable vision for each of the tokens in the token setting to determine how much they're allowed to see. You can also make any token emit light, whether it's a lamp or a magical player. Mod scripts, available to Roll20 Pro subscribers, provide a powerful way for you to customize and enhance your games. These can be accessed via the mod script options in the drop-down menu of the game's detail page. Mod scripts can speed up game prep, automate spells, and streamline combat. Once you reach the mods setting page, go and navigate to the script library tab. Within that tab, you can select the drop-down menus titled Roll20 Mods Script Library to search for scripts available with one-click installation. The scripts are sorted by various functions that they perform, such as extending a character sheet's features, performing a utility task, changing dynamic lighting, or modifying tokens. When the script is open, simply click the Add Script button at the bottom of the page to install it. Once you click the Add Script button, the mod will restart and the page will refresh. You will know everything went successfully if you see a new tab next to the script library with the name of your script. And last but not least, another powerful feature available to Roll20 Pro subscribers is the Transmogrifier. The Transmogrifier allows you to take elements like pages, characters, decks, handouts, macros, and more out of any of your games and put them into another game that you own. The Transmogrifier tool is under the Experimental Features section of the My Settings tab on the right sidebar. Once selected, the Transmogrifier window will open with the current game pre-selected. To copy things between games, simply choose the two games you want to use in the drop-down menus. A listing of all the objects in the games that are eligible to be moved will appear. All you have to do is drag and drop between the two lists to copy elements between the games. Something to note, you're copying elements, not moving them, so the original will remain the same in the first game.